Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday morning in the old cookbook show. Today we're going to do a recipe out of this 1931 Knox Gelatine cookbook. It is subtitled Dainty Desserts, Candies, and Salads. I have a whole collection of cookbooks from gelatin companies from about this time period, from the early 1900s to just before World War II. And they're all pretty much the same. They all really sort of push this idea of gelatin is more than just a sweet dessert. And the salads and things in them are something that really sort of took off post-World War II. I mean, they were big in this time period, but post-World War II, you really saw a move forward. And you see a lot of cookbooks from the 1960s and early 1970s that present these Jell-O salads that are a little bit strange to me. I know that my great aunts and my mom made these, and they always showed up at family suppers and family gatherings. And then they died away. There are still people who make them. They still occasionally show up. They're not as big as they used to be. But in the 1930s, when this was published, they were really sort of pushing out this idea that you take gelatin and you stuff whatever you want inside of it. And one of the things that I have a problem with is that sometimes they're sweet and savory, and sometimes they have textures that don't quite go together for me. This one that we're going to do today is called meatloaf. And after studying these books for quite some time, I landed on doing the meatloaf one because it's mostly savory, or it's all savory. There is no sweet component. We're going to start out in this glass mixing jug with one package of Knox gelatin, still made today, and it is probably the only one on the grocery store shelves where we live, or the major one on the grocery store shelves. And to that, I'm going to add some cold water. And we're just going to give that a bit of a stir and let it rehydrate. Now, the recipe says that if you make the full recipe, it serves 12, but feel free to cut it in half and only make it so it serves 6. And I think that's an interesting comment for the recipe to make. When you're cooking at home, don't be afraid to double or triple a recipe or cut the recipe in half. For most recipes, you can do that at home. There's no threat of not getting it right by doubling or tripling it or cutting it in half. I know a lot of people are afraid of that. So in this pot, I put some beef stock, and it says to well season it. So I'm going to put in some extra pepper and some salt. Then I'm supposed to add in some celery, which I've chopped up, and a little bit of onion, which is chopped up. And I'm going to bring this to a boil and let it boil for 3 minutes. Okay, now I strain out the solids. We just want the liquid. We're just imparting the flavor, I guess, into the beef broth in case it wasn't flavorful enough. Smells really good. Smells really good. Now, it says to put in a little bit of lemon juice, except if you're using beef. It gives you a selection of meats that you could put into your gelatin meatloaf. I've decided to use beef, so I've got some ground beef that I've already cooked off. We don't have to put that in yet. But it says that if you're going to use ground beef, put in Worcester sauce. So, let's see, how much should we put in? Let's give it a few really good shakes. There we go. That's about a tablespoon. We'll give that a stir. Now it says to let this cool until it starts to stiffen. This was 1931. It was during the Great Depression, but it was also the dawn of the refrigerator. And if you had electricity and you still had a bit of money in your bank account, apparently you were buying refrigerators, and refrigerators were selling like hotcakes in this time period. So into the fridge just for a little bit. Now it calls for a little bit of chopped up parsley. So there we go. That's ready to go. Beef is ready to go. Pimentos are ready to go. And this has thickened up, probably a little too much. I probably left it in the fridge too long. And it's that fine line that I have never quite grasped between not enough and everything sinks to the bottom, or too much where it gets a little bit clumpy. But in goes the ground beef. In goes the parsley. And it calls for just a few of these sliced pimentos. Now, if I wasn't following the recipe, I would put in some sliced hot peppers, hot pickled peppers. I would put in maybe a pickled cocktail onions. I think all of those would go really well in this mixture. So we're gonna give this a mix. And it's kind of interesting because there's way more add-ins than there is gelatin. Now, instead of one giant mold, I'm gonna put it into four little smaller individual molds. Let's see if I even get four. Who knows? Actually, this works out perfectly. I'm just gonna get two individual molds, one for each of Julie and I. How perfect is that? She's gonna be so pleased. So I'm gonna stick these in the fridge to let them come together completely. And we'll pull them out for tasting in a little while.
Hi, Glen.
Hey, Jules.
Hi, friends.
Forks.
Yeah. Okay. You mentioned this, and I had my usual response to Jello things. I'm sure I've mentioned this before. There's a distinct generational thing in my family. Those who like Jello salads and stuff, and those that don't.
Well, this is though, building on, this is the easy, convenient...
Tureen?
Yes.
Yeah,
so
it's tureen.
It's building on something that has, hundreds and hundreds of years of...
Yep.
of
And I know that I'm being unfair, because I know that I often really like Jello things, but I always forget, and anyway, let's try.
It's quite nice with the red pimentos and the...
Looks lovely.
And the green parsley. Yeah. Maybe a spoon would have been better. Let's see.
Wait, one, I am being too harsh. It's like a chilled, hot weather meatloaf. I'm still not fully convinced, but I think the parsley wins me over.
That is like picnic in the park meatloaf.
Yeah. Yeah.
Really refreshing, isn't it?
I would probably put something with a little bit of a bite in it. But
so as I was filling these, I said, pickled hot peppers, or little pickled cocktail onions.
Mmm.
And put those in, and so you'd get a little bit more of a, but the depth of flavor is pretty good. I'm kind of surprised.
As I rail about how much I'm not sure I'm gonna like it, because I just haven't. Carrots and Jello.
No, I think grated carrots and Jello are a step too far for me. But that's good. I like that.
There you go.
Maybe a little bit more pepper, maybe a little bit something to give it a bit of bite.
There you go, for your next picnic.
Knox Gelatine Meatloaf from 1931. It's a winner. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.